Using an emulator for any console can be useful. You might emulate to upscale your games to 4K, or you might use it as creating or loading mods is easier on it. There are two emulators for the Switch, these being Yuzu and Ryujinx. Both have their pros and cons, but I will only be going over Yuzu in this video. Both emulators require you to have a modded Switch though, so follow my guide here if it's not modded already. Yuzu doesn't require you to have a top-end device, so it's more compatible with lower-end computers. Conversely, Ryujinx is more intensive. The specifications here don't guarantee beautiful full-speed gameplay, but instead lay out a cost-effective recommendation while still taking into account the performance. Lockpick RCM is needed to extract your keys. You can download that here. Tegra Explorer is used to extract your firmware update. You don't need it if your game doesn't require system files, like if you're playing ACNH, but games like Mario Kart 8 Deluxe do. NX Dump Tool dumps your games to an NSP or XCI to use with Yuzu. NX Dump Fuse will merge the files into one part if your game was split into multiple. With the files downloaded, insert your SD card into your computer or open up FTPD. Drag lockpickrcm.bin and tegraexplorer.bin into the bootloader payloads folder. Then drag nxdumptool into the switch folder. As stated before, some games require the system firmware to be played. If your game doesn't need the system firmware, then skip this section. Boot into Hikate, then tap on payloads. Click on Tegra Explorer in the list, and once it's booted, select firmware-dump.te. Select the Dump System MC option. Once the dumping process is finished, press any button to return. And then select Reboot to Bootloader / Update Bin, which should take you back to Hikate. Boot into Hikate, then tap on Payloads. Click on Lockpick in the list. And once it's booted, select Dump from Sysnam by pressing the power button. You'll see some flashy colors and the confirmation that the keys are written to where they needed to be. Press the power button again to return to the menu, then navigate to Reboot to Hikate. Now boot your custom firmware and launch any game via Title Takeover, opening the game while holding R. It's better to launch homebrew apps this way as it gives them full system resources. When the homebrew launcher opens, navigate to NX Dump Tool. Here, the process differs a bit if you own the game physically instead of digitally. Press Dump Game Card Content if you do own it physically, otherwise press Dump Installed SD Card / EMMC Content. If you have a physical game, choose the XCI dump, and if you're dumping an eShop game, choose NSP dump. If it's available to you, dump the base app and the update or DLC. Make sure Split Output Dump is also selected, and you can trim the output dump if you need the extra space. Now select Start XCI / NSP dump process and wait for it to finish. Insert your SD card into your computer or open up FTPD. Your firmware dump will be here, your keys and switch, and your game dump and switch, NX dump tool, NSP, or XCI. Copy your firmware dump, your keys, and your game dump to your PC. If you have an external game drive, you might want to move them there to save space. If your game was dumped in parts, use NX Dump Fuse to merge the files into one part. If it was dumped as one file, then you can skip this section. Extract the version of NX Dump Fuse that you downloaded earlier and open it. Set the input to one of the parts and it should auto-detect the rest. Next, set the output folder. Select Fuse and the app will merge the files into one at the output folder. If you had multiple games dumped into parts like this, repeat the process for the rest. Install Yuzu here. Yuzu on Windows requires the latest version of Microsoft Visual C++, which you will also have to install if you don't have it already. If you're on Linux, you can download the app image or Flatpak version of Yuzu. Open Yuzu, and on first boot, you should get an error that you haven't installed your keys yet. You'll have to go to File, Open Yuzu Folder, and it should take you to App Data, Yuzu on Windows, or equivalent on Linux. Create a new folder here, called Keys, and drag your prod keys and title keys into it. For your firmware, you want to copy all of the NTA files to App Data, Yuzu, NAND, System, Contents, Registered. You'll have to create the folders if they don't exist already. Now, double-click the main window to add your game directory. If you dump the update or DLC as well, go to File, Install Files to NAND, and select the update. It will install it to the main game. Once it's done, you can double-click on any game to open it. If you're getting bad performance or want to increase the resolution, go to Emulation, Configure. Make sure multi-core CPU emulation is turned on. This allows Yuzu to use 4 cores instead of 1. If you're going to mod with Yuzu, make sure to have extended memory layout enabled. For some games, mods will use more RAM than a Switch can provide. The extra memory allows heavy mods like that to work without issue. It's recommended to leave your CPU accuracy on auto, but if you're on a lower end system and want to trade accuracy with speed, set accuracy to unsafe. Check everything under unsafe CPU optimization settings. If you're on AMD, you will get a significant performance boost if your graphics API is set to Vulkan. If you're on Nvidia, you will get a significant performance boost if your graphics API is set to OpenGL. If you're on Intel, you'll have to test and see which works better for you. No matter your GPU, make sure to enable Use This Pipeline Cache, and use asynchronous GPU emulation, and accelerate ASTC texture decoding. In this panel, you can also change the full screen mode, aspect ratio, resolution, etc. For the Revolution, I leave mine at 2x for good compromise between sharpness and performance. For the window adapting filter, it's mostly up to feel, as of what you'd like, but here's what I'd recommend depending on your use case. Once again, these options are personal preference. Use them all first and decide yourself what you like best. I do recommend setting anti-aliasing to FXAA, whether or not you're scaling. Make sure to enable Use Asynchronous Shader Building, and use fast GPU time if you want to force all games to run at their native resolution, and anisotropic filtering to 4 or 8x for better looking graphics. Thanks for watching. Please like the video and subscribe to see future modding tutorials. Leave a comment or join my Discord if you have an issue, and I'll do my best to respond. My website has this video and future ones that aren't in video form completed, so if you'd rather read something now instead of waiting for the video, go ahead.